What I want to do here is give you a tour of Final Cut Pro from start to finish using a project. Let's import some media. Here we have a shoot that was done with two cameras and the corresponding audio mix. Let's select all three items to import. Next, I will select all three items, right-click, and create a new multicam clip. Everything was captured at the same time, so the good thing is we have common audio since the cameras also capture sound. So let's label this with the name of the song, which is Little Star. And here we go. Final Cut just synchronized all three items. We can double-click on this new item, which is a multi-camera clip. And let's do some quick labeling and organization. I will relabel these items. So first, this is the mix. Here is the guitar angle. And the next thing, the vocals. And in order of priority, I will put the vocal as the primary angle, then the guitar, and I'll put the mix at the bottom because we won't really interact much with it since it is a constant throughout the edit. Next thing, let's start editing. For that, we need to create a new project. File, new project, and I will also label it with the name of the song. Let's drag in our multi-camera clip. And as I can see here, I have a little bit of a gap at the front. You know, the waveform only starts about here. So let's trim this beginning and create a small transition. And let's take a listen. Looks like we're off to a pretty good start. If it was at a different angle, I could always right-click and choose a different active angle for the beginning. But guitar is fine. And as far as audio, we are already on the mix, which is great news. The singer comes in a bit later here.
Looking around me.
So we need to switch to her. So to do that, I need to visualize all of the angles. Let's go to the viewer menu here and choose the angle viewer. And now we can see both of our video angles. And before I switch, I have to make sure I'm in the correct mode. So let's make sure that we only switch video and not sound. We're going to stay on the same sound, which is the mix. So let's go and do that. And to switch, I'll simply click on her angle.
Looking around me.
There you go. If my timing was off, I can always trim this transition here. All right. And I will just continue and edit the song all the way to the end. All right. Looks like I'm pretty much done. Let's fine-tune the ending. So here I will do a little bit of trimming and also add a transition. Maybe a bit longer. Slow fade out at the end. All right. That is perfect. And now that this video is finalized, let's give it an overall look. To give us a little space, I'm going to turn off the angle viewer. Let's select everything, right-click, and turn this into a compound clip. So that pretty much merges all the edits into one big chunk, and I can apply the effects. So let's give it a bit of a style here. So in terms of color, I can throw a black and white effect, but the trick here is to turn it down, and that will give us a bit of a desaturated effect, which is quite nice. The next thing to give it a bit of a vintage look, we can add a vignette, we can look it up. And here it goes. It's a bit extreme, so let's back it off a little by backing off the size and maybe a little bit less darkening. And here's the before and after processing. And then it's pretty much ready to be shared with the world. So I'll just select my project, go to File, Share, and Social Platform.